Be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Help us grow. So we're going to get this excavator up on this berm and start building this up a little bit. Eventually what we're going to have is a little wider berm and higher berm. And wider so that we can get the little excavator up there or skid steer and add material to this berm as we have it and as we need it. Now on the other side of this berm is pretty steep drop off and goes down into a valley there. So regardless of what you do up there, you got to be extremely careful. Now one of the reasons I decided to bring this material up here and get it up on the berm right now is the simple fact that the stuff is pretty wet, and because it's wet and will compact, I can get it up there, kind of compact it in, run over a little bit, build it up, and it'll be really good to go and won't tend to be affected too much by the wind, and you know, have the winds basically blow the dust and dirt off of it and all over everything down there and down through the valley. It'll basically make a more stable berm when it's all said and done. Thank you. rough terrain forklift with the bucket on it. I'm going to push basically where I move these cars and stuff. Kind of push this down, angle it down towards the drainage that I built, which is on an earlier video, by the way. And gives me more material up there on the berm to use on it. That's approximately the area where their U-Haul box truck used to always get stuck. It'd just sink. And actually the front tire of that Super Duty sunk right there when we parked it. I may have to dig that nasty stuff out of there and put some rocky stuff in to replace it. Years back, this used to be just a pretty gradual hillside going down into the valley, and I decided that I needed a parking area for some of this stuff, so it was kind of out of sight and out of mind. Thank you. Now up at the top of this berm is basically just as wide as the two tracks on that excavator. And I've got to spin this around basically in its own footprint, with, you know, keeping in mind that it's pretty steep off the backside and there's no recovering it back there. Who knows where it would end up. Getting it back up out of there would be a horrendous job. So got to be careful, not mess up here, and keep it on top of the berm. I'm going to work this excavator up, keep working more material on both ends of it until I get the kind of height that I'm looking for on this berm. And when it's all said and done, I'll just push a path down to take it off the hill. So I'm going to end this here and make it a two-part video because it's just getting really long. And I was trying to show the intricacies of putting this machine up there on the berm and building it up with the machine and making it higher, making the machine higher. And it just turned into a long video. So here's the end of part one.